Hi everyone, I am Arafat Rahman. Today I am going to present a paper titled Deep Learning Based Surface EMG Hand Gesture Classification for Low Cost Myoelectric Prosthetic Hand. The paper ID is 176. The other authors of this paper are Nazrul Nahid and Dr. M.A.R. Ahad. At first, I would like to share you the motivation behind our work. Do you know that around 3 million people are suffering from arm amputation? Sad but true, most of them are from developing countries. By losing hand or forearm, they lose their working ability, which leads to mental trauma and economic crisis. So, keeping these things in mind, we designed Diu Fab Hand, which is a special type of prosthetic hand. It is named after FabLab Diu, as the resources has been provided by this lab. In ICIV 2019, we have a paper on this. In our previous work, we mainly focused on hardware. Now, our goal is to give this hand a better functionality. For that, we tried to establish an algorithmic pipeline using continuous wavelet transform, CWT and transfer learning, and CNN-LSTM. The main contributions of this work are shown here. Firstly, both TL and CNN-RNN are developed to compare accuracies and performances. Secondly, continuous wavelet transform is used with CNN-LSTM for EMG signal analysis. And thirdly, the control schemes developed here are not only suitable for controlling Diu Fab hand, but also any other prosthetic hand with closer configuration, and it is suitable for real-life application. In this slide, I am going to show our proposed method with a flowchart. At first, raw EMG measures are taken from two open source EMG datasets. Then, these signals were amplified and filtered. Then, these signals were sampled. After that, a non-overlapping sliding window of 256 milliseconds was used to segment the signal. Then, each window goes through CWT to make a 2D image of the signal. Finally, weights of different neural networks are transferred, and modified CNN-RNN architectures are used to classify those images for different hand gestures. In this slide, I am going to give a brief description of CWT construction from each segment signal. The continuous wavelet transform, the definition of continuous wavelet transform is given here. The continuous wavelet transform is a function of x of t, which is defined here with the equation. At first, 250 millisecond window was chosen, and 85 coefficients were calculated by scaling and shifting a mother wavelet for each data points. So in dataset 1, the image matrix has size 85 by 1000, and for 2, it has size 85 by 125. The values of these wavelet coefficients are treated as pixels of the image with various color intensities. In this slide, I will give the reasons of using CWT. The first reason is it gives a joint time frequency representation. SEMG is a non-stationary signal with varying frequency components with respect to time. So, only time or frequency domain features are not adequate to classify or differentiate between different hand gestures. For instance, fast Fourier transform is a well-known frequency domain feature, but it will give almost the same output for index movement and thumb movement or other different gestures. This is true for other frequency or time domain features. CWT can capture those time-varying frequency components and create an effective joint time frequency representation. Here we can see the bright spots in the higher frequency portion of the graph indicate abrupt changes in the signal, whereas in the lower frequency portion, they indicate smooth transitions or oscillations. Therefore, we used it. The second reason, it has good time frequency resolutions. Different gestures have different patterns of smooth and abrupt oscillations. CWT can detect these changes. CWT images for different hand gestures are different, while for the same gestures of different trials, it is quite similar. Here we can analyze the resolution problem more deeply. In the time domain, the signal has only time resolution. In frequency, only frequency resolution. Like CWT, the short time Fourier transform or STFT is a method for creating time frequency representation, but it cannot resolve different events of a signal as good as CWT because STFT has a fixed window length. In contrast, in CWT, the window sizes varies. Looking at the signal with longer times gives better frequency resolution, and at shorter times, better time resolution. So CWT has good resolution for both frequency and time. So for classifying different gestures, CWT was chosen. The datasets have been used as shown here. The first dataset is known as Ramikushaba EMG repository. Here 10 classes of finger movements were performed and these finger movements are shown here. Second dataset is UCI machine learning repository. It has two parts, UCI dataset 1 and 2. 6 classes of graphs were performed here. You can see the graphs here. For classification, we have used two different types of techniques, TL and CNN LSTM. For transfer learning, we used AlexNet and ResNet 18. For CNN LSTM, we used modified BubbleNet and ResNet 18 as CNN and our own designed LSTM. At first, a featured extracted sequence was extracted from CNN. Then, this sequence was given as input to a BioLSTM network with 500 hidden layers. For a dropout layer and then a fully connected layer with an output size corresponding to the number of classes and a softmax layer was constructed. All the sequences are partitioned as 80% training data and 20% for testing. From this table, we can see the accuracy comparison of our methods with other methods applied to same dataset. Here we can see modified ResNet 18 plus LSTM has achieved highest accuracy of 99.83, 99.73, 99.23 in all three datasets. We can also notice AlexNet also performed good in RAMI and ESA dataset. Here we can see the confusion matrix. All the gestures were classified perfectly with very few error. It is for ResNet 18 plus LSTM. Here we can see the training progress graph of ResNet 18 plus LSTM in two datasets. Here it shows the training and validation accuracy and loss with respect to iteration. From this graph we can see no overfitting has occurred. Though ResNet 18 plus LSTM has given better accuracy, we are developing a control scheme for real-time use of a low-cost prosthetic hand. So in terms of complexity, AlexNet is less complex here. So AlexNet takes the least time with 34.51 milliseconds and 41.72 milliseconds in two datasets. From previous slide, we can also notice that AlexNet has also a good accuracy. From the confusion matrix of AlexNet in RAMI dataset, all the gestures were classified accurately with very few false positive and false negatives. The most confusing activities are middle and ring finger and thumb and little finger movement as they are quite similar. As less convolution layers are used in AlexNet, that's why this problem remains. But considering real-time usage and very small prediction time, we can ignore this error. So from our finding, AlexNet is the most suitable net for real-life application as it has less computational complexity with very fast accurate prediction. Now I will show a demo simulation of gesture which was performed in MATLAB using the classified signal as the input. Here you can see that real-time movement which was performed simultaneously. The performance in both cases are quite close. Here for time constant, we have shown one movement, but if you want, you can contact, we can give you the videos, other movement videos. Here basic gestures of our hand are shown. We tried to use this hand for grabbing different objects. Again, for time constant, we have not shown any video, but if you want, you can contact, we can give you other videos. The main focus of this paper was to design a control scheme that may give the best performance for DU5 hand. Our main contribution is establishing and finding an algorithmic pipeline with the combination of CWT, CNN, LSTM architecture to get very high accuracy, which will be suitable for real-life application. From our finding, we can see that though ResNet 18 has very high accuracy, it is not suitable for real-life application for its complexity. But AlexNet has performed very well in this regard. So we take this as the main contribution of our work. For future work, we want to test our algorithm with our own created dataset. So that's it. That's my presentation. That's the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.